Hello everyone, I'm Ragy. You are watching News Magazine in our own voice. Nowadays, there are so many different kinds of online games around the world. Almost all of the young kids have ever played online games. However, there are still people who play games in a traditional way, that is, tabletop games. Playing tabletop games is different from playing online games because people meet each other in person while they are playing tabletop games. Besides, there are also whole lot of different kinds of exciting tabletop games around the world. Some of them are really strategical, while some of them are totally hilarious. So, in today's feature story, we will take a look at tabletop games in Taiwan.
政治现金，然后一二三四五六七八，对，好，我要讲民调，三个票仓，这是安全，绝对不会当选。好，小鬼也塞给自己，抽三张好了，抽我，抽我，我又可以抽二。
在自己的出版阶段，可以塞一张妨碍核心书包。这个，我相信
recall the first time I well quote unquote came in contact or played a table game was when I was about 10 years old, and at that time my art teacher took the whole class on a camping trip, and she brought a tabletop game called the Zitato. And at that time, I was fascinated because it had like little cute gold coins, and they were shiny, and it had cards which had brilliantly illustrated artworks. So at that time, I thought it was a cool concept, and I did not really care about how the game was played. I was more interested in the small aspects.
The little things.
Yeah, the small aspects of the whole thing. So one day, my friend brought a game, and he said that it was interesting. It was like some other game I had played before. And then, so I thought that I had nothing better to do at the time, so I played it, and that game was The Message. And at that time I thought it was quite a nice game, so it was about 3 or 4 years ago when I first started to play a tabletop game.
So, except for those little things on it, with those table games, what other aspect that you like those tabletop games?
I find that tabletop games are interesting because they create something like a pseudo reality. It's like it's about the same concept as when you are playing an online game and you play as some character. It's about the same thing, but in a tabletop game, well, let's say in The Message game. Okay. So when someone is now a character in that game and has the abilities of that character and has to do the things that character has to do, then that person really has to try to become that character. It's not like in real life that we have to try to be what the world wants us to be. In a tabletop game, you can just be what you are or what you need to be.
So do you really go into that character or go into that role in those games when you are playing those tabletop games?
Well, most of the time, not really. Not so into that character, but really more or less a bit, and quite a large bit. And by going into each different character of each different side, then some people will have like their inner darkness might come up. So sometimes if the person is like perhaps happy all the time and passionate, stuff like that. But sometimes in a tabletop game, they can become really cold and collected and calculating. And I think that is quite a fun aspect of this game because we can see a lot.
So I'm very interested about the first game that we played is something called 美丽岛风云.
Yeah, it's the Wonderful Island.
Oh, I think that's really that is a beautiful game because you can see a lot of drawing picture on it, and this is comic like drawing, kind of make fun of our politicians. So if I want to know more about this game, so do you think that this game is also the kind of same game that you can be yourself, or you can go into the character as we have talked about The Message before?
I think it's I think it's not as much. You cannot, because these political characters, they all have their own character. They are they're already quite, in some way popular, and we all know what they are like. So it's really, so it's quite hard for us to become dumb. I think that game is nice because the game is really designed well, and the abilities of each character really have something more or less to do with the real political figure.
So, oh yeah, really
yes.
Make fun of them.
Yeah.
Really curious. Okay. Usually, in my mind, I thought that those kind of card games are Western lives. I mean, they are all about the, they are all come from the Western countries or Western world. But nowadays, you can see those kind of tabletop games that playing with Taiwanese politicians or else. So, what is other kind? Do you have played other kind of Eastern or Asian tabletop games?
Well, as I mentioned before, The Message is one of the more Eastern tabletop games.
Uh-huh.
The Message is based off a movie in China, and it was about when the Japanese came and attacked mainland China.
So where did you meet your friends and play those tabletop games?
If you really want to play like more than the tabletop games that we have, we usually go to tabletop game shops.
As far as you know, how many tabletop games here in Taiwan, or in Taipei?
You mean game shops?
Yeah, tabletop games shops.
Well, the tabletop game shops that I more frequently visit are around Gongguan.
Okay.
There are two tabletop game shops there, and the one we went to was one of them. There was also one that I really liked in Yongchun. And there was another one in around Taipei Main Station, and perhaps a few more around there, but I only went to one of those. Usually we go out as a group, and we might spend 5 to 6 hours there. Like from 2 in the afternoon to around 6 to 8, and we go have dinner and then we go home. It's like almost a regular meeting for us.
Oh, so you meet one time each week?
Yes, most of the time.
Is there any website or Facebook group or community in Taiwan that we can meet other friends that play tabletop games?
Yes, there are, and there are also many extracurricular groups.
Okay,
that
like
have
clubs.
That, yes, clubs. Like we have one tabletop game club in Zhengda ourselves.
Okay.
And I remember that there's one in Sida, maybe in Taida, I'm not sure.
Okay. So maybe there are a lot of clubs in the campus.
Yes.
And we can figure them out. Okay, thank you for being here with us.
That's all for today's feature story. I hope you could enjoy playing tabletop games someday in the future. There are two links to the Facebook groups of Taiwan Tabletop Games below in the comment. You can join them if you want. Thank you for watching this video. I'm Reggie, and you are watching In Our Own Voice. Bye!